going to talk about a journey of change, which I call a passion of adventure. I have been always in the private sector, and I wanted to be an engineer, a programmer, but when I failed, I was promoted to a manager, as you know. Then when I failed as a manager, I was promoted to a CEO. So then I started learning career planning. And what's, so I said, I must have a career plan, because I didn't like what the HR people are doing for us, huh? Trying to control our lives. So I said, if I fail as a CEO, I'll be a consultant. Any consultants here? I love you guys, no, I don't mean it. But if I fail as a consultant, I will run for parliament and be a politician. In Kuwait, if you have nothing to do, you run for parliament. Which I may do soon, because I have nothing to do. Okay, so the first case was ITS. ITS is a small company that was an IT venture. It was a joint venture between Kuwait Finance House. At that time, they were just starting, and they needed investments in areas other than selling chicken and stuff like this. And they had a joint venture with an English guy called Gilbert Pant to set up an IT company to do big, large systems for multiple industries. Anyways, after 5 years of working in ITS, I was a project engineer. Then I was promoted. I still do not know why. But at the age of 30, 31, they have forced me. They said, no way, you have to be the CEO of the company. And I told them, I'm just a kid. I don't understand it. I was supposed to be a technical guy. I don't know anything about the business. I don't know anything about the business, the finances of the company. It turned out that the company lost its capital in those 5 years, 3 times. So I had a great performance along with the whole group who was running that company. But I didn't run the company, I was an employee. And then, of course, we had to turn around this company. And just imagine, at this age, no experience, probably some knowledge on the technical side, nothing on the business, and then you have to turn around an IT company which is have been failing for the past 5 years. So it lost its capital 3 times. We had to change its business model to become a systems integrator. If you know the IT industry, system integrations is the toughest type of IT business. But then, alhamdulillah, after 1 year, it became profitable for the first time. And then for 12 years in a row, it enjoyed very high profitability with ROI of almost 40% in that regard. It was really at the bottom of the market. Sorry, I can't hear me? No, I'm too loud anyways. And I have a very beautiful voice. I'll sing. If we have time, we'll sing for you. Profitable for 12 years with high growth and profitability. If you ask at that time in Kuwait or in the Gulf, who is the worst IT company, the big ones, they'll tell you ITS. The brand image was totally demolished. Then it has become really the leading by 1996. In the whole area, we were nine countries. We have moved from $5 million of revenue, hardly, with negative, to $100 million later on. The second case, you all know. The first case was a turnaround case. The second case was a high growth and transformation case. MTC, as you all know, was only in Kuwait, and we had to take it global. It was in one country in 2002, 2009, 23 countries. $2.5 billion of market value. By 2007, it was $32 billion of market value. We had this strategy, the 3x3x3, If you add them, it's 9 years. If you multiply them, it's 27. So we wanted to do in 9 years what others do in 27 years, from regional to international to global. By the 2007-2008, Zain has become the fourth largest company in the world, mobile company, in terms of geographic coverage. It covers 60 million kilometers, square kilometers, and 700 million people, and we had 72 million customers. Revenues have grown from 500 plus million in 2000 to more than $8 billion in the year 2009. Customer growth from less than half a million customers to over 72 million customers. When I left Zain, we started a new company called Ila. Ila bil Arabi, yani min Ila. Many of the people who invested with me, they asked me, Ila ayn? I say, I don't know. I know min, bas Ila madri ad. Enjoy the journey, huh? It's a passion for adventure. Okay, so we started Ila in 2002. We have a number of companies. The most 90% of our work is in the US. We have a company called Red Lambda in Orlando, Florida. Red Lambda is going for an IPO in 2019. It's a cybersecurity company. And the other company is called Beyond Limits. That's a joint venture between us and Caltech. You know Caltech. Caltech is California Institute of Technology. They do all the NASA CIT, Communication Information Technology products. We took all of these products they developed for 15 years in a joint venture with them. They asked me to be the executive chairman of this company, which I was wondering why. And then, of course, as an Arab, they asked me to be the chairman immediately, even if I'm not qualified yet. لنا الصدر دون العالمين أو القبر هاي الثقافة مالها. So this company, alhamdulillah, which was established 2014, our largest customer in the world now is British Petroleum. Our first telecom customer is TEDxKuwait of Japan. No Arab telecom company even looked at our face. But alhamdulillah, we have TEDxKuwait. So. And this company have just become a unicorn, a $1 billion valuation. We established it for a capital of $20 million. So how did we do that? This is not my word. This is the words of a great guy called Benes. Benes is the leadership guru of the world. Ideas, relationships, and adventure is what you need in order to succeed. Your leadership should be managing how to manage this architecture. Ideas, relationships, and adventure. So if you want something new, you have to stop what you are doing. An idea that is not dangerous is unworthy of being called an idea. And this is the context. I mean, you have to manage ideas, relationships, and adventure in a very complex context, which is your local context with all the stakeholders that are pressuring you, your shareholders, the regulators, the market, competition, and all of these things. And then you have to, if you want to go global or international, then you have another round of massive pressures in that regard. And you have to manage this context and the gist of it, the content is your culture. How to develop an internal culture that is commensurate to you being a leader in your field. And this is the toughest job of a leader. It's a very complex process of learning and restructuring in the same time. There is no time for studying and researching and so on and then doing. You have to do and research and study in the same time, because action is a surer way to the future than analysis. So what's the essence of leadership? It's change, managing change and leading change. The success of a leader is not how good looking he is, or is he has a charisma. And I'm sure you know about a lot of charismas which are al-fadi, صح? Because there is nothing on the ground, nowhere. A leader, you are as much a leader, as much change you can impact on your group, on your organization, on the community. So change equals leadership. So change is the very essence of leadership, and change means transforming the emotional, the intellectual, and the behavioral state of the group. This is my model, because I got a PhD, so I have to support, and I deserve a PhD. So I start inventing. Of course, I lecture to my people. They have to fall in love with it. Otherwise, you know, what happens to them? It's the typical story. So this is, it's leadership. We've talked a bit about what's the importance of leadership. And leadership is not part of the difference. It's all the difference. And by leadership here, I mean a process, a community of leaders. I don't mean the one single man, Antar ibn Shaddad, who falls in love with Abla and can kill 1,000 people in 2 minutes. Huh? That's not the type of Superman leadership. Leadership for me, it is a collective leadership. And you as a leader, you manage the process of leadership as a CEO. But you're not an absolute leader, huh? That is ridiculous. You need a core team. The core team is the most important aspect of this, any enterprise. Of course, you need a strategy. You need to see where you're going, but more than a strategy, you need strategic conversation. What does strategic conversation mean? Means that if you are a leader that keeps preaching about customer service, and if you talk about it, everybody's behavior is a result of the most dominant idea in his mind. So people must see that you are conversing with all of your people at any condition. You are conversing about customer service and really caring about it. You go to the call center and you talk to people. You take special care of the call center. This is what he did in Zain when MTC, when we started. We went to the call center and lived there and changed it in a year time from the worst call center in the whole Middle East to the best, to number one in 3 years in a row. And then, of course, you need the culture, which is the gist of what you do as a leader as well, and change, and you need core competences. If you can put all of these things together, that all results in success. And this is our HR philosophy. And this is our HR manual and HR systems. The 5 F's. People, you must achieve the five F's, environment for your people. You must care about their future. Their future is your future as a company. They must make a fortune. That's why we had stock options imposed in ITS. That's why our new company is a full partnership with all the people who can add value to this company. But you don't bring people work for you as slaves. You are the only one who makes a fortune, and they live on salary and bonus and all of this. Freedom. Let people work where they want. So engineers who have expressed that they want to go to do marketing, we put them in charge of marketing. And marketeers who wanted to run an engineering group, we took them and made them running there. They drove them crazy, but that's fine. And then fitness. And when I talk about the fitness, please don't look at me. Today I am a bit, no, fitness, I mean social and technical fitness. And finally, it's fun. Because if you are not in business for profit or for fun, and profit, fun before profit, what the hell are you in business for? Thank you very much.